Hey, my name is Jeremy Aweda. I'm a student in a city called Rostock in the north of Germany. It's very close to Denmark. It shares the same sea as Denmark. Yeah, but currently I live in Munich. Because I have to do some student job at a company. So I'm currently living in Munich, in Bavaria, in Germany. And it's one of the states that have been really hit with this corona crisis. So about in February, on the 11th of February, I traveled to school because I had to take some exams in the north of Germany. And yeah, my friends were teasing me that you're coming from Bavaria because then we had just recorded one case of coronavirus at a company. And then I was like, oh, it's not important. It's just going to go away and it's going to fizzle away. And then we just laughed it off and we had a good time. And yeah, shortly I came back to Munich and just continued work as usual. And then on one of the Friday nights, I was out with a couple of friends. Yeah, we just went to a Nigerian bar and we were just gisting. And then I received a text message from my flatmate. Yeah, she said that I should come home and that I need to stay in my room all through until she gets tested. That a pastor in church had tested positive to the coronavirus. And then I was really shocked because I thought it was so far away, but this was it right there. My flatmate was in contact with someone that had coronavirus, and she had hugged him and kissed him goodbye when she was leaving her city to come to Munich to do a student job as well. Yeah, so I was really confused. I didn't know what to do. And the company where I work has already set up a task force where you are required to report that kind of information to them. So I texted them, and then they responded immediately and told me to just stay in my room and not come to the office. So it was really confusing. I didn't know what to do. Just had to stay indoor and my roommate as well because we share everything. We share the bathroom, we share the kitchen, cutlery, and everything together. So there was nothing I could do. I just had to stay. And then she got tested and yeah, it came out negative. So I could already go back to the office after a couple of days. And now the situation has gotten really bad that it's almost everywhere. So for us now in the company, two people already are infected with the virus and the department has to be shut down, and the people in that department cannot work again. And in the whole floor, everywhere is closed. Now, the problem for me is this: if I do not work, I cannot afford to pay my rent, my health insurance, all my bills. How do I pay it? It's just a really, really tricky situation. Yeah, testing would have been the best thing. So let's just get everybody tested. Let's know who has coronavirus, who doesn't have. Let's do it so that there'll be a plan. But the Robert Koch Institute, that's the German, I don't know, like their CDC, like the German CDC, so to say, says that the capacity of German testing is it can only carry out 160,000 tests per week, and that is really nothing. It's not effective. So this is really it's a really big crisis. I don't know how things are going to unfold in the next couple of days. Yeah, as of yesterday, I was still able to work, and I'm very grateful for that. I'm lucky that I'm still able to work. And today, the government in Bavaria here announced that everybody must stay at home, and there are going to be police just on the streets enforcing and making sure you have a valid reason to be on the streets. So you are not allowed to work in pairs, you have to separate yourselves, and yeah. It's a really complicated situation right now, but I hope this goes away very fast because if it lingers for long, I will not be able to pay my bills anymore, and I don't know what is going to happen. And yeah, it's a terrible situation. I hope it goes away very fast. Yeah, please stay safe.